Okay, Mr. So, most of the food crisis, of course, that we've experienced lately could have been avoidable through timely decisions and perhaps more aggressive campaigns against smuggling, particularly that of onions and sugar. Let's talk about smuggling now. What is the feel that you're getting on the ground as to the strides of authorities and this government to take control of smuggling of agricultural produce?
Next time, smuggling is... still come in, no? We checked the United Coop trade record for the past year. Last year, it reached around 30 billion.
Right.
And last year, around 25 billion. But to establish the first border inspection area, and all goods will go to the area, it will, we see a good future for our countries and for those who trade, we can say that the businessman who import legally, this is good for them. You know? For those illegal who imported illegally coming into our country, they have a big problem with this one. So ang tingin natin is magandang direction yan yung ating pangulo to check everything na pumasok dito sa ating bansa to have the first border established, and this will help our government to stop the smuggled goods coming into our country.
Okay, Mr. So, moving on to another hot topic in the agriculture sector, the leadership of the department. Now, there's no indication that the president will relinquish the portfolio anytime soon. Are you happy that he continues to be the DA chief, or would you have wanted him to appoint a secretary now?
No, we think na kailangan pa ng tensya as another year, no? Mas effective kung ang ating pangulo is magiging secretary ng agriculture din, dahil kung may problema, no, ang mga magsasaka, we could reach him and tell him kung ano, saan ang problema, and he will understand. Like for instance, the biofertilizer overpricing, when we saw that some the official want to buy biofertilizer at 6,000 per 5 grams. So we let the president know, and he stopped it immediately. So we see more less corruption if he'll be the head of Department of Agriculture.
Okay, Mr. So, let's talk about modernization now. Now, across many administrations, of course, the past leaderships have been cognizant of the fact that modernization is key to improving farming capabilities and capacities. Now, will this stay as an aspiration for now? Because we really, the reality on the ground is we are still lacking against our other Asian neighbors in terms of modernization of agriculture.
Yeah, Stanley, if you can see, no, Our country has improved very fast because of the rice tariffication law. The rice tariffication law, the tariff collected will go to the rice farmers. So we have more machineries now to harvest our palay. If 5 years ago we are harvesting our palay for around 15 days. For the area, now we just harvest our palay in 3 to 4 days. So malaking improvement ito, no, yung machineries na binigay ng itong rice tariffication law, and we ask Senate and Congress to have the same with the hub and poultry. So may batas na ginagawa ngayon, yung Livestock and Poultry Development Fund. Mm-hmm. So the tariff collected from imported pork and chicken and other agri livestock and poultry will be allocated to livestock and poultry, local livestock and poultry. That will help our local producers.
Lastly, Mr. So, and in closing, as President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. delivers his second SONA, do you still expect agriculture to be as prominent as it was during the first State of the Nation address last year? And perhaps, what do you wish to hear from the President as regards your sector?
I think more irrigation, number one. Number two is impounding for those rice area, more impounding dam, small dam for other farmers uphill, no? And of course we need to bring the tariff back to normal for the port industry, because yung tariff ng port was go down, no, from 30% to 15% to 20%. So dapat ibalik na yung tariff, no, para to encourage the hog raiser to come back. Yun ang nakikita natin. With the first border, kung ma-check yung mga produkto na papasok, malaking bagay yun. We think na the president is on right direction. And of course, the soil testing. Nabanggit ni Presidente about soil testing. We have to test nationwide soil testing to know what nutrient we need in planting our rice and other agricultural products.
All right. SINAG President Rosendo So, thank you so much for being part of the conversation today. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you, Stanley.